Today I will show you a mystery, thriller film from 2020, titled Alone. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. Jessica is seen opening the doors to a U-Haul trailer. She starts packing up her stuff inside, from her furniture to her bike. She leaves her plant behind. Jessica walks to her car, barely manages to start it and leaves town alone. She makes her way through the open road, listening to an audiobook, headed for her next destination. Suddenly, there's another car on the road in front of her, driving slower than her, though not by a lot. The Jeep signals her and she tries to pass him, but as soon as she does, he speeds up and doesn't let her join the lane. There's a truck ahead of Jessica, so she speeds up and makes it back on the right lane. The man in the Jeep then signals her again, then drives off in another direction. She stops the car to gather her thoughts. Later, Jessica is at a gas station and calls her dad, while she waits for the gas. She tells him that she wanted to talk to him and not her mom. The signal's a little bad, but she manages to tell him that she already left. Her dad's confused, because they were supposed to help her pack. Jessica says that she wanted to avoid her mom, but he interrupts her explaining that both she and he are worried about her. She tells him that she'll be fine, then turns around and notices the black Jeep from earlier slowly driving behind her. Jessica ends her conversation with her dad and leaves the gas station to continue on her journey. Later, she's in a motel, caressing the wedding ring that's on her necklace. Her phone rings, but she doesn't pick up because it's her mom. She lies in bed looking at pictures with her late husband and gets upset. Jessica lies awake in bed and looks through the window. She sees the black Jeep pull up at the motel parking lot. The next morning she's woken up by her alarm. She gets in her car and sets up her GPS, but before she can start it a man knocks on her window, scaring her. Jessica cracks open the window and he asks if she recognizes him, then points to the black Jeep. It unsettles her. The man apologizes for the situation on the road they had the previous day, saying that he wasn't paying attention. He tries to make small talk and tells her that he knows the area. She says that she's headed up north. Then he wishes her a good trip and leaves. Jessica drives away from the motel and into the woods. Her mom tries to call her again, but she doesn't answer. As Jessica continues driving, she sees the Jeep stopped in the middle of the road. She stops behind him, but doesn't leave the car and locks her doors. Jessica tries to drive around the Jeep, but the man stops her and asks her to open her window. He tells her that his engine died and she offers to call him a tow truck. The man would prefer it if she could give him a ride to the nearest gas station, but help him get his car out of the road before they leave. Jessica tells him that she's in a bit of a hurry and that she could call the nearest gas station to tell them where he is. The man insists on his plan, so she apologizes and drives away from him, freaking out. That night, she's still at the road when she reaches a stop and decides to take a rest. Jessica lights a cigarette and calls her mom finally. They talk about her leaving early and her mom asks her if she's there yet. Jessica tells her that she'll be there sometime tomorrow. Her mom thinks it's a bad idea for her to leave so early after what happened, but she thinks that it's time to move on. Suddenly, the Jeep pulls up behind her again and she rushes back to her car. When she gets in, she has a hard time starting the car and before she drives off the man from the Jeep walks over to talk to her again. She stops a little bit down the road and he knocks at her window saying that she almost ran him over. Later, Jessica is driving and she sees him behind her again. She calls the police and tries to explain what's going on, but can barely keep it together. The Jeep passes her and speeds up, so she tells the dispatcher that it was a false alarm. A little after that situation, Jessica begins losing control over her car. It starts to swivel on the road, until she finally manages to get it to stop relatively safely a bit off the road. Jessica gets out of the car and checks it, only to find that the trailer's tire has been slashed. Suddenly, the Jeep appears again and approaches her car. She can't unlock the trailer or start the car. The man smashes her window in and comes inside. They struggle, but he hits her and sedates her. The following morning, Jessica wakes up in some kind of room. She can barely stand up, still drowsy from the drugs he gave her. There's nothing outside and she can't make anything out when she peeps through the door. She hears the man outside and begs him to let her out, but he just awkwardly smiles at her. Night arrives and she's still there. Jessica can hear him walking and whistling outside of the room. He walks in and finds her hiding in a corner. Jessica asks him what he wants from her and offers to give him money to let her go. She tries to bargain with him, saying she won't tell anybody. The first thing he says to her is that she's not the first to say that, then tells her to take her clothes off. Jessica begs him to use the bathroom and when she goes for the door, he knocks her over and locks the door. He drags her back to the corner and sits down next to her, hushing her. The man tells her that he was the one to slash her tire, then shows her a video of her and her husband doing a card trick. Jessica cries and the man holds her, asking if he's worried about her. He sees that her wedding band is on a chain and asks if he left her. She tells him that he died and the man insists for her to tell him how. Jessica tells him that he killed himself with a gun. She cries and the man keeps telling her that it's going to be okay. He leaves the room and locks the door behind him. The next day, Jessica hears some kind of machine running outside and immediately goes for the door. She sees that the key is still inside the hole and tries to get it, but fails her first try. She sees a nail on the beam next to her and gets it out. Jessica uses it to get the key. She unlocks the door and goes up into the house. The noise outside stops and the man gets out from his car, so she hides before he comes inside the house. The man sits down to eat, cutting pieces of cheese with a hunting knife. His phone rings and he lies to the person on the other side of the line that he's at some beautiful hotel. The person is his wife, who thinks that he's on a business trip. He tells her that he'll get back in a few days, when the deal is done. Jessica listens to him talk to his wife and then to his daughter like a normal person. He says goodbye to them, stands up and puts his knife back in its holster. When he goes downstairs after Jessica, she bolts out of the door toward the woods. The man realizes that she's gone and goes searching for her. Jessica hurts her foot and falls on the ground. She pulls the branch out of her foot and lets out a scream while doing it. The man hears her and runs toward her. She reaches another hurdle on her path, goes around it and goes toward the river. He's catching up to her and she sees him coming. He reaches her close to the river, so she jumps in it. The currents of the river are fast and strong and they carry her further downstream. At one point the river becomes calmer and she gets out. Jessica is now stranded somewhere in the woods with her hurt foot and her captor possibly still on her trail. She's lost and in pain, but she treks on. Suddenly, Jessica hears the sound of footsteps and she hides. As the footsteps come near her, a man can be seen in the background. She hits him with her walking stick. The hunter Robert tells her to get down on her knees and she begs him to help her because someone is trying to kill her. He gets his phone to call the police, but she broke it when she hit him. Jessica begs him to get her out of there and Robert keeps questioning her. He asks about her foot and tells her that he has extra boots in his car. They reach his car and he gives her the shoes that belong to his wife. Both of them enter his car and drive away through the woods. Inside the car, Jessica looks at herself in the mirror. Robert asks her if she's alright and if she's hungry, then he tells her to get a sandwich out of his backpack. She eats one and gets some of the water he has there too. As they're driving, he tells her not to worry about the man that's after her, that he's probably long gone. They reach a problem on the road, there's a fallen tree in the middle of it. Jessica freaks out saying that the man did that and gets out trying to lift the tree off the road. Robert helps her, but they can't move it. He says that he doesn't know if there is another way out of the woods. Suddenly, the Jeep appears behind them. Jessica jumps for Robert's shotgun and tells him that the man in the Jeep is him. Robert takes the gun away from her, telling her that he'll handle it. The man walks out of the car, seemingly talking to someone on the phone, saying that he found her. He tells Robert that she's his sister and that she ran out of the house when she had one of her episodes. Robert tells him what Jessica said he did to her. The man sticks to his story, saying that she went through the tragedy of her husband dying and lost her mind. Robert doesn't know what to believe, so he still keeps protecting Jessica. She tells him that now that he's seen his face, he won't let him out of the woods alive. The man keeps acting like she's his sister and goes to grab her, pushing Robert away, who doesn't know what to do. Jessica screams for help and tells him to ask for his phone to call the police. Robert asks for the phone and Jessica escapes. He stops the man from going after her and tells him that he needs to call the police and make sure everything checks out. The man gives Robert his phone and quickly tackles him over, pounding him with his fists. He grabs his gun and shoots him. Jessica escapes deeper in the woods. The man is after her with Robert's gun. That night there's heavy rain in the woods, as Jessica is seen finding shelter in a cave. The man is right on her trail. He shines a light toward the place where she hides and taunts her by whistling the same song as before. At one point she thinks that he's gone and goes outside, when he shoots her. She keeps going though and he keeps following her. Jessica crawls on the ground of the woods, so he can't see her. He says that he knows that she's hurt and that he shot her. He tells her that she has about 2 hours before she bleeds to death and tells her to come out to fight him while she still can. The man leaves the gun on the ground and gives her 1 minute to try to grab it. He continues to taunt her and starts talking about her husband's death. Jessica is getting angry, but she holds her position as he keeps insulting her and her husband, trying to play on her guilt. He tells her to show him that she's brave and come after him. When he realizes his trick didn't work, he tells her that he'll find her, then he takes the gun and walks away. Later, Jessica is seen still walking through the woods in the rain. The following morning she wakes up and immediately starts walking, getting away from the trail. Jessica navigates the difficult terrain of the woods, when she suddenly hears the noise of an engine. She sees the truck come back and the man getting out with Robert's gun. The man gets Robert's body out of the trunk and starts dragging him away to bury him. As he's disposing of the body, Jessica decides to go to his truck. She can see him digging as she opens the door and just inside. Unfortunately, there is no key. She looks for it, but she only finds a phone. The man is coming back to the truck, so she hides in the trunk. He thinks he hears something, but proceeds to drive off. Jessica grabs the wrench he has in his trunk, then calls the police from his phone. She can't speak too loudly and begs the dispatcher to trace the call. The man reaches for his phone, but when he can't find it, he stops the car to look for it. Suddenly, Jessica jumps out and hits him with the wrench. They fight as he tries to drive the car. She takes his knife away, then tries to strangle him with the wrench. She loses her grip, so she grabs his knife and stabs him. The car swivels around and runs off the road. Jessica pulls herself out of the car and as she lies on the road, she sees a helicopter flying above her. She follows the sound it's making to see where it will land and gets to a clearing. Meanwhile, the man gets out of the car and gets prepared to come after her. She calls his wife and asks her if she knows where he is, when he appears in front of her. Jessica tells her that he's a kidnapper and a killer. She puts him on speaker and his wife calls for him. Jessica tells the wife her full name and says that if this is the last time that she hears from her, it will be because her husband had killed her, just like he killed Robert. She throws him the phone and he puts it in his pocket, then goes after her with the knife. Jessica is ready to fight and doesn't let him off easily. They struggle in the mud, until he cuts her again and goes to kill her, but she bites his shoulder. Jessica grabs the knife and stabs him. She waits for him to die. Suddenly, the helicopter can be heard. Jessica is saved. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you can watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.